And let's now get an update on the situation at the Manila North Cemetery, which is expecting over 1.5 million visitors for the Undas break. Rafael Busano is there with the latest. Raf, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. That's right. You know, it's that time of the year again when families and friends gather in the different cemeteries to visit their departed loved ones across the country. Now, the Manila North Cemetery is one of the biggest cemeteries here in the National Capital Region. From October 30 to November 3, it is expected to get visitors of up to 1.5 million Filipinos from different parts of the region and possibly from nearby regions as well. Now, aside from visiting their relatives, people here are also expected to visit the graves of popular personalities, including politicians and celebrities. Now, unlike previous years, the entrance isn't filled to the brim, and it's actually quiet. And the lines actually are quiet well, and they're now way more organized. Visitors can expect free rides from the entrance of the cemetery through or via electronic tricycles to different points of the cemetery, which is open from 5 a.m. to 7 p.m. From October 30 to November 3. Now, this means that spending the night, similar to practices in previous years, is no longer allowed. As you can see behind me, all vendors are situated here outside the cemetery entrance. So visitors are advised to bring their own food or buy them from one of these vendors prior to entering the cemetery gates. The usual reminders still stand, Carmina, and these include the prohibition of alcoholic beverages, sharp objects, and even gambling paraphernalia. Road closures near the cemetery are in place. They're in effect, which is why those usually plying this area are advised to check on the social media pages of the Manila LGU. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Rafael Busano there joining us live. Let's now check on the traffic situation at the North Luzon Expressway from our correspondent Victoria Tulad. Hi, Victoria. How's traffic shaping up?
Hi, Carmina. Traffic here at the North Luzon Expressway, or NLEX, is still light with the bulk of motorists expected this afternoon. According to Robin Ignacio, head of the NLEX Traffic Operations Department, a number of motorists were recorded as early as 6 a.m. today. And given that volume, NLEX needed to open a counterflow lane from Balintawa, Quezon City to Marilao, Bulacan. Traffic then eased up and is expected to get heavy again at around 2 or 3 p.m. this afternoon. The congestion will last until around 10 p.m. to midnight and will resume again before 5 a.m. tomorrow, November 1. A 10% increase in the daily average of vehicles is expected for Undas 2024, which means around 363,000 are expected at NLEX from today until November 4, while 85,800 are expected along the Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway or SCTEX from today until Monday as well. The NLEX management says some motorists may start coming back on November 2 to avoid traffic, but majority will most probably travel on November 3 up to the early hours of November 4. Ignacio says choke points are the Balintawak Toll Plaza and entries to Valenzuela and May Kawayan, Bulacan. At SCTEX, the bottleneck usually happens at Tarlac. To ensure the safety and convenience of everyone, NLEX has deployed more than 1,500 personnel to assist in the payment of toll and those who will experience problems on the road. Free towing is available for Class 1 vehicles. The NLEX management has also instructed gasoline stations to have 24/7 mechanics ready to aid those who will be in need. Ignacio reminds the public to install RFID and remember to have enough load for faster payment of toll. Those who will fail to do so may still opt to pay in cash, although this may result in an additional 5 minutes in your travel time. And as always, motorists are reminded of the blow baguettes, which means to check your battery, lights, oil, water, brake, air, gas, engine, tire, and self. Meanwhile, at the South Luzon Expressway, traffic is still also light. Carmina, for those who have questions or problems, motorists may call the NLEX hotline 135,000. That's 135,000. And the SLEX hotline 0917-687-7500. The weather right now, Carmina, here at NLEX is a bit gloomy and it has been drizzling earlier, but skies have cleared up, but motorists are still advised to be extra careful in driving. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Victoria Tula there, joining us live. More passengers arriving at the Batangas port. Dennis Dato now joins us with the latest from there. Dennis, over to you.
Carmina, all the passengers continue to arrive. The situation here at Batangas port, one of the largest ports in the country, remains not congested. This is contrary to expectations that the number of passengers heading home to the Mindoro provinces, Pamblon and several provinces in the Visayas would increase this morning. However, according to the management of Batangas port, a surge in passengers is likely later this afternoon since most people have still work commitments. Weather is also improving here in Batangas, allowing the resumption of trips for small boats or fast craft heading to Calapan City and Puerto Galera. Earlier inspections were conducted by the Philippine Ports Authority, the Philippine Coast Guard and Marina, and the DOTR Assistant Secretary for Maritime, Julius Llano, to ensure that there will be no disruptions with expected influx of returning passengers. Assistant Secretary Llano assured that there are enough vessels operating and that Marina has issued a relaxation order. This means that even if it is not yet the scheduled time for their trip, vessels can set sail as long as there are enough passengers, aiming to prevent congestion at the port. However, some shipping lines have complained about delays in docking and departing due to limited ramps available at Batangas port, as 5 to 6 ramps are blocked by a cargo vessel that ran aground during the onslaught of Tropical Storm Christine. According to Assistant Secretary Llano, they are working to remove the cargo vessel so that the ramps can be used by arriving and departing ships at Batangas port. Starting today, it is expected that the number of passengers will reach 20,000, with 15,000 already recorded last night. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Dennis Dato, there joining us on the line.